Welcome back with one more video clip. This is 5 minutes clips. Now today we are seeing about heating units and cooling units connection to HVAC system. Geothermal heating and cooling only we are going to see. Geothermal, you know that how to use the heat effect from our earth for heating and cooling applications, right? Let us get into the slides so that you will get a nice idea. After that, if you want, you can come back and read this theory. So here as a small diagram how we are going to cool or heat our room, and the ducts are mainly conducting the air from one place to another place. Red color indicating that heating is done and blue color indicating that cold air is getting in, and exhaust is nothing but the outer air which is going through outside. Okay, so assume that we are going to make some heating and cooling effect for this room. Now let us go. This is the cooling mode and heating mode arrangement. If you are seeing this image, you will get something difficulties. I am telling, cooling mode, we need cold air, that is in, that is the output what we want. So heat exchange will take place, hot air will go to outside, right? If you are seeing the summer, it will be very hot. Okay, and heating mode in winter, we need supply air should be hot. We need to heat the input air, it should be hot so that we can enjoy the comfortness in winter. For making this thing, we are say putting our ducts inside the earth. As you can see, heat dissipation over here, heat is absorption over here due to the temperature difference. Here you can see input is hot water, output is cold water. Input is hot water is getting in, so inside the earth it is chill, so it will absorb the heat and the cold air or cold water will go to here outputs. So in the winter we need to heat, so outside is too cold, that will go inside the earth. As compared to the outside condition, inside of the earth will maintain some temperature, that because of that temperature the heat between the cold to earth will be exchanged, so that it will absorb the heat from the earth, inside of the earth, and the hot waters will go to here, it will supply to our home. This basic and simple principle which is used in this geothermal heating and cooling. Still, if you have any difficulties, you can refer this diagram. In cold, you can see from the house cold air is coming from the earth, there is some constant temperature was maintained, so that temperature was absorbed by the cold water, then it will going to the room again. Similarly, in hot summer, outside is so hot but earth is maintaining some temperature, same temperature, so hot air is coming, it do heat exchange is take place and it going back to the house. That's it. So for this type of heating and cooling, one, we can use two types of pipes. There is one is horizontal field, another one is vertical field. These things will be junctioned in the heat pump for increasing the temperature, right? So you can see how it is work. So heat pump, reverse thing of heat pumps will give the refrigeration effect. So in summer we need cooling, so heat will be rejected over here. In winter we need heat, so heat will be absorbed in the heat pumps. This is a simple principle how we are using heat pump for both seasons, right? And still, if you have any doubts, you can refer this thing. First, system pulls the cold air from the home. Yes, cold air from the home will go to the geo outer unit. It absorbs the heat from the cold air outside into the refrigerant. Yes, absolutely. Then it will make up warm, it will go to the room. So the hot warm air will be roamed around the inside of the buildings. Later, if it is cold, it will come back to here. Similarly, it will be reversed for summer. And for making the hot or hot air, we can use the furnace. As you've seen so many English movies are, it will be available, it will be in the base or ground floor or bottom side of the building, so that we can use this furnace to heat up. You can use furnace oil, wood, coal, etc. to generate the temperature, high temperature, so then it will pass through the building by using the duct. As you can see, ducts are very useful for transporting these things, right? And you can see that some of the fuels, wood chips, pellets and logs, etc. If you want, you can use furnace oil, waste oil or anything if you want, if it is not harmful to you and the environment. Okay, biomass boilers also here, they are used, right? Radiators are available to liberate the heat to the room Right. So in winter, in most of the places in our inside NIT Patna campus, you can see they are putting some air heater, electrical heaters. There's a coil will be there. It will be heat due to the electrical power supply. After that, once you are forcing the air around it, hot air will be come out. Right. And heat gain and loss, there is some principles are available: conduction, convection, radiations, right? These are the three things which going to make heat loss and gain during the winter and summer. You know that conduction is nothing but one place to another place transmission of heat through a medium. And if you have to know about conduction, soon I will upload one more clip, you can refer. And these are the cooling effects, right? And this is in centralized air conditioning unit, which I already discussed in the previous slide. If you have any doubt, you can use. Previously we have seen with cooling coil only. Here we are using heating coil. That means in winter we need heating, not the cooling. So that time the cooling circuit will be off, heating circuit will be switched on, so that air which is returned from the duct will go and sensed by the thermostat, then according to that heating will be adjusted in the heating coil, so that we will get hot air. It will be supplied to all the buildings. Type of heating systems and small heater unit, central unit, radiant and solar heat, radiant unit heat, nothing but if you are using halogen lights to generate the heat. Central heat, just before only we have seen. Unit heater is nothing but the electrical heater, small thing which you are used in your room, right? Solar heat, we are using solar energy to generate the heat. And if you see the greenhouse, they have made glasses over here and you can use that one. And these are all things which is covered over here, and the fuels, nothing but. And I love to thank everyone and the web sources. Keep on touch with this video clip.